Okay, in this lecture, we're going to examine the razor view syntax in ASP.NET MVC. So you have learned that here, we can write C# code by prefixing it with an at sign. To render the list of customers, we can simply use a for each block. So at sign for each var customer in model.customers. We use a code block here. This is compulsory in ASP.NET MVC views, even if what you're going to put inside the for each block is only one line. Now here, inside this block, we can either continue writing C# code, like using an if statement, or we can write HTML. So the view engine in MVC called Razor View Engine knows how to parse this syntax. Let's say we want to display these customers using list items. So outside this for each block, I use the UL tag. Let's close it here. And inside the for each block, we use li. And here we switch back to C#. So @ customer.name. We can also use an if block to conditionally render content. For example, if no one has rented this movie before, we want to display a custom message. So if model.customers.count is 0, code block. Here we can add a paragraph. No one has rented this movie before. Or if you don't want to use the p tag, you can simply use text. This is not part of the standard HTML, but it's something that the Razor View engine understands. So if no one has rented this movie, this if block will render our text without any markup around it. Okay, now we add an else block here and move this UL right here. So you can see working with Razor Views is pretty easy. Now, let me show you a few more techniques. Let's say here in H2, you want to conditionally add a class popular if the movie has been rented by at least 5 customers. Otherwise, we don't want to have this class here. How do we do that? First, we use a code block. So @ code block. Here we can write any C# code. So I'm going to declare a variable, call it class name, and initialize it like this. If model.customers.count is greater than 5, it should be popular. Otherwise, it should be null. Now here, we can render class name. With this code, if class name is null, this class attribute will not be rendered in the final HTML. It will be added only if class name is popular. So let's try it. Run the application with Control F5. Okay, right-click the heading. Inspect. Look, we don't have the class attribute because currently we have only 2 customers. Now let's go back to the view. I'm going to change this condition to greater than 0. Save. Now we don't have to recompile the application because this is just a view. So we can switch back to the browser, refresh. Now look at the heading. We have the class popular. So this is how you render classes dynamically. By the way, this technique is not limited to classes. You can use this technique to render any attributes dynamically. And one last tip. You can add comments in your Razor views using this syntax. @ star, star @. And we can make it multiple lines. This is a comment on multiple lines.